And the timer's right here, babe.
Okay, great. Keep an eye on it for me, Jennifer.
Look at so, the pile of paper. Oh, my God.
Well, the reason is, as Dr. Moore said, I am not really a legal expert or anything, but I have been trying to do something. And that's really what it comes down to, do something. And that's the first thing I wanted to talk about, do something. You can send an email. You can write a letter. Right now, as of last night, we found out we have two bills in Texas that are being heard on Wednesday, House Bill 922 and House Bill 926. House Bill 922, it's a minor change in the law. It would just say no-fault divorce can only take place if there is mutual agreement. You cannot force divorce on a person. How radical is that? Did you force somebody to marry you, or did you agree to marry together? All 922 would say that you must have mutual consent with no-fault divorce, as it takes place right now in Mississippi and South Dakota. So when I said do something, well, let me go with the other bill first. House Bill 926 basically extends the waiting period from 60 days to 6 months. It's a minor. We would love to see it go further, but right now we'll take what we can get. Do something. I would encourage everybody here, and if you're watching by live stream or video, call our Texas representatives. Call our Texas senators, email our Texas governor, our Speaker of the House. The committee that this will be heard in front of is the Juvenile Justice and Family Issues Committee. The same bills actually passed out of committee in last session, and the Texas Family Law Foundation, that wonderful organization, which I would say is the enemy of the family, even though they say they're the Family Law Foundation, they helped to sabotage that. One of these bills passed out of committee unanimously. Democrats, Republicans, men and women, everybody said this was a good bill. And the Texas Family Law Foundation sabotaged it. The other one also passed out of committee on a partisan vote. But the deal is this. They need to know we're watching. And there are other people that have said, if you do this in Texas, my representative will do this in my state. My senator will introduce something in my state. So Texas likes to lead the way. Let all eyes be on Texas, and I'm begging you, please, call on our behalf. Second thing I would just say is be there. You know, when I think about the one man who says half of life is just showing up, that's really what it comes down to. If there's a town hall meeting that you get to meet your representative or a senator or something like that, just be there. If you have a representative, go to the office, visit them. If you're in the Capitol, visit your representative. Be there and say something. Which is the next point, is just say something. When I go to the town hall forums, I think that most people know what I'm going to address. And sometimes it gets difficult. Sometimes you feel like you're quaking in your boots. But you've got to find somehow, even if your knees are shaking and your voice is trembling, say something. And at the same time, you'll find that as you do that, you'll be encouraged and enabled to say more. But it's not just say something. Also, don't be afraid to challenge some of the lies. This whole divorce industry is based on a house of lies and fraud and deceit and destruction. And I think we do not have to apologize for vigorously challenging things for our families. As people have said, it's not just the spouses, it's the children, and it's the grandchildren. When you get divorced, you are impacting your grandchildren, and we need to say that. Don't sugarcoat it. Don't cover it up. And expose the other side. So the Texas Family Law Foundation, aka the Texas Anti-Family Lawless Foundation, in my opinion, the enemy of the family, as far as I'm concerned, in the state of Texas. Not to say that they're all bad on everything, but we need to talk about what they're doing. They bragged after the last session how they had people in place and they sabotaged the bills that were passed out of committee so they never got to a vote. These nice attorneys. By the way, some of them have never been through divorce. Some of the ones that are married have no idea, don't have any children, and yet they talk about the best interest of the children. Which to go to Edward Kruk, what exactly is the best interest of the children? The PhD that somebody mentioned last night, Article 3 of the United Nations Convention talks about the rights of the children and everything. The best interest of the children is the primary consideration in all actions concerning the children, whether undertaken by public or private social welfare institutions, courts of law, administrative authorities, or legislative bodies. It sounds so nice. Nobody knows what it means. He is an expert in this field, the founder of an international council on shared parenting. He says nobody knows what it is. Furthermore, when we talk about the best interest of the children, most people think about the physical needs, the emotional needs. There is so much more to a child. Moral upbringing, spiritual upbringing, social functioning, the ability to work through conflict. These are all things that children need to see. Anybody who advocates divorce and then says the best interest of the children, they are lying to you. The best interest of the child in almost every single instance is to be raised in an intact family with his or her natural father and mother, period. I find it very hypocritical for those who talk about the best interest of the child to be profiting off of the destruction of the family and then piously pontificating to us. Challenge them. Share resources. We can't do everything on our own, but we do have, I mean, this is one of the things that I find so amazing is people that share resources. So I've got a few that I would like to share. This is the Attorney General's opinion, Ken Paxton. It is, and you'll see that almost everything I have is all written up and notes all over the place. But this was issued in February 22nd, 2019, very recent. Opinion number KP-0241. I believe in his opinion. He has given us enough ammunition to take the Texas Family Code in its unconstitutional areas, to take it apart, to dismantle it. This is a document from the Attorney General of the state of Texas. We need to use it. I also believe at the same time, too, it gives us the ability to undermine and to take apart the unilateral no-fault divorce system. Another resource I'd like to share, the Russian effort to abolish marriage. 1926, July of 1926, this was written by the Atlantic magazine, that bastion of conservatism, right? But, you know, they are talking about what happened in Russia. And as I said last night, the divorce laws we have in America are, for all intents and purposes, the exact same thing that were imposed upon Russian society and Bolshevik Russia by Vladimir Lenin. They had a national debate because they saw how destructive it was. Abortion skyrocketed, homeless children, orphans, broken-hearted widows, or broken-hearted men and women. Just the continual changing of parents or of spouses. One person said, 2 minutes left. Ooh, I better hurry up. So I'll continue on real fast. That happens. Thank you for keeping. So the taxpayer cost of divorce and unwed childbearing. You can find this online. The taxpayer cost of divorce and unwed childbearing. Well, we're fiscal conservatives. We're not social conservatives. You cannot be a fiscal conservative if you do not address social issues. Second chances. This is a proposal put out by two secular people. One is the former Georgia Supreme Court Justice Leah Ward Sears, about a proposal to reduce unnecessary divorce. They start talking about unnecessary divorces. How many people do not need to be divorced? Leah Ward Sears wrote about it because she had a brother who went through a unilateral divorce and later committed suicide. There's the ACP. This is the American College of Pediatricians. They've written an impact paper on what public policy should be. If you are a pediatrician, you should be advocating for family and for the repeal of no-fault divorce. Other issues, like Judith Wallerstein, the unexpected legacy of divorce, a 25-year study. Devastating. She was actually for divorce until she did this study. The effects of children on divorce. Anyway, there's many resources out there. Dr. Stephen Baskerville, his book, Taken Into Custody, like I said last night, it was the one thing that helped to get me through to say that I wasn't completely insane. Layla, thank you so much for your book on primal loss. I've used that many times, and I will keep using it because that is the testimony of children. The last thing is mobilize others. We can't be everywhere. We can't do everything. Do what you can to get others involved. If you can't be there, let somebody else be there. I have a YouTube channel. If you look up Jeff Morgan Unilateral Divorce, you'll see my YouTube channel. And I post about everything almost exclusively on family issues. I'm not saying that I'm the best. I'm just saying I interview people that are the better, okay? But it's something to try to help mobilize other people. And that's what we need to do, take our stand. I'm going to let these two guys talk more about the legal things. This is just what I try to do from my perspective. Thank you so much for listening.